Today, I'm going to show you how to implement a faster Google Analytics tag on your website. So you see right here, I'm using the header footer plugin to implement my Google Analytics tag. And you can see that I'm referencing googletagmanager.com/gtag, yada, yada. In here, I have my Google Analytics number, or a fake Google Analytics number. And we'll go and take a look at how the waterfall looks for this particular site on GT Metrics. So if we look at the performance of that particular JavaScript file, we'll notice that it takes 146.4 milliseconds to load. That's pretty quick, but we want to get that down a little bit and also load this tag asynchronously. So what we're going to do is go back over to the website and copy the Google tag ID. Now we'll go over to plugins and disable the header footer post injections plugin. Now, if you have other things in your header and footer and you happen to be using this exact plugin, then disabling it will also disable those other pieces of code. So you might not want to do that unless that's something that you want to do. So we'll go ahead and add a new plugin. Type in CAOS, and you can see host Google Analytics locally. Click install now and activate. All right, so we'll head over to the CAOS settings. And normally this wouldn't be here, but we could go ahead and act like it's not there and click paste. And you can see that's where to put your Google Analytics tracking ID. We're going to set this to asynchronous. Usually it's set to default. And then we want to make sure that we pick a place for it to load. In this case, we're going to pick the header. So we'll go ahead and click Save Changes. And you'll notice it says your cron is running healthy. Analytics.js last updated March 3rd. And it tells us when it's going to update it next. Now, if you do have some advanced analytics, you can also use this particular plugin with those advanced analytics plugins. For instance, WooCommerce, Google Analytics integration. And these two will link up to make things load locally. So now we have our Google Analytics JavaScript loading locally, and we want to go ahead and test it out. So let's click clear cache, head back over to GT Metrics, and we'll retest. Now the three things we're looking for. Number one, we'll see if the load time goes down. It may or may not, depending on the network conditions. Requests should go down, and then we should also probably see a lower load time here. So let's take a look. All right, so the load time hasn't really changed, probably because we're talking about shaving off a small amount of load. You can see that our requests went down from 23 to 22. We'll go take a look at the waterfall. So as you can see, the analytics.js file now takes 73.4 milliseconds to load. It's loading asynchronously, and so it took about half the time to load that it did before when it was going to a remote server. So that's how to make your Google Analytics JavaScript load locally, and I hope that tip helps you out.